We're live now, Ben. We'll put that out of here.
Shopping Centre Minor Football Championship Final underway here at Amore Park, Portlaoise. A bad evening for football here in Portlaoise, but it's Greg Cullen against Port Arlington. And Greg Cullen in traditional red and green will play from left to right, but Port Arlington win that first breaking ball through their midfielder, Colin Murphy. He's looking for options, but he's overrun that one. A touch of early nerves from the young Port Arlington man. Port Arlington, of course, in their traditional maroon and green and white. The famous green sash was once part of their jersey. And still is tonight. Greg Cullen moved that ball well downfield, and that will just go to show you how slippy conditions are. That was Luke Hand, the man from Heather Hill. Good run from Hand. Inside the 45, goes for the shot, but he just pulls that to the left. And out comes the Port Arlington goalkeeper, Ross McGrath. And he played to his Ronan Coffey, who seems to be playing a sweeper role in the opening minutes of this game, and a long clearance down towards Scott Osborne. Fine, big, strong corner forward, Scott. Nice man on the ball too. Feeds it into Jack Foster, their captain, who in turn sends it to Jamie Connolly. The layoff is good, and Port Arlington interlinking very well in the opening minute here in Portlaoise. But the referee has spotted the first foul of the night, and it will be a free just inside the 45 for Port Arlington. Greg Cullen defending this one, quickly taken. It's now with Owen McCann, and he runs through the 45 in towards Jamie Connolly of Port. Left footed kick for him, and he's got the first score. And a well-executed score from the small corner forward. Connolly has made it 1 point to Port Arlington. No score, Greg Cullen. Greg Cullen line out with Ger Kieran from Fatherburn Park in goal. Martin Dial from the Loughlin Road at number two. Tunde Ogunfowara from Tommy Murphy at number three. Sean Farrell from Heather Hill is the left corner back. Right half back is Kyle O'Brien. He was a member of the CBS team earlier in the year, but Port Arlington are having the better start here. We'll get back to the Greg Cullen team in a moment, as Port Arlington look for the second, and Colin Slevin has sent that one in from the 20 metre line, and he executed that brilliantly, but Greg Cullen found wanting in defence, and I think there is a touch of nerves out there at the moment. And the rest of the Greg Cullen team: Jared Brennan is at centre half back, Paul Mulready from Oakley Park is at number 7. In the middle of the park, Trevor Collins from St Clair's Road. He's partnered by Jamie Sheehan from the numbers. And in the half forward line, Dean Kelly from Barrow Road. Brian Byrne, the captain from the Collision Road. And Luke Hand from Heather Hill. Where's the number 12 shirt? Tomás Brennan from the Crook Lawn is number 13. Ryan O'Grady, number 14, a full forward. And Dan Lyons is at top of the left wearing the number 15 shirt. So an infringement and a free out. Match referee tonight, David Moore from the St. Joseph's Club. Standby referee is Vincent Dowling of O'Dempsey's. And his linesman, Arthur O'Connor from Cornwood. But it's Port Arlington and Ronan Coffey. Nice player, good ball in field. And a great Cullen goalkeeper has got to get to that chair, Kieran. And he does find the goalkeeper for a minor. He looks for options. And he goes short to his centre half-back. That's Gerard Brennan who gathers that. Gerard just hops that ball in front of him. He's looking for options. Greg Cullen just want to keep possession here. And now Paul Mulready gets his first touch. Greg Cullen still playing around with that. But as we all know, possession 9/10 at the low. And you've got to hold it on a difficult night like tonight. 15.5 degrees in Portlaoise, but the rain falling heavily since around 4:30. So it's raining 3 hours now. And the Greg Cullen lads making a longer trip of 21 miles here to Portlaoise. Port Arlington doing quite well in the opening exchanges, leading by 2 points. Jamie Connolly and Ronan Coffey on the score sheet for them. But again, Greg Cullen defend. And Jared Kieran
He falls to the ground. He's taking a little bit of a knock there. The referee's allowed play to continue. Danger for Greg Cullen here. They've got to be good. There's an overhead kick, but that's pulled way to the right. Now, can it be kept in? Yes, it can. Danger here. That's a pull from behind. He's given the point. Good advantage from the referee. But Port Arlington are off to a flyer here. That's 3 points for Arlington. And the Greg Cullen goalkeeper receives a little bit of attention. Meanwhile, we'll give you the Port Arlington line-out. Their home pitch, of course, is McCann Park. Greg Cullen people will have memories of 1981, where the Leafs senior final was played that day. But unfortunately, it was a loss to Greg Cullen against a star-studded Port Leash team, while the redevelopment of O'More Park, where we are tonight, was taking place. Their home pitch is McCann Park. The club was founded in 1893, Port Arlington. And now Greg Cullen can get on their bikes and look for their first score. Luke Hand. Hand goes forward. Great traditional name of the Greg Cullen club. Hops it, picks his spot, kicks it beautifully. Is it there? That's an excellent score from Luke Hand, from Heather Hill. And it's Greg Cullen's first, and that should settle down the boys in green and red. Playing from left to right, 2 points between them. It's Port Arlington 3 points, Greg Cullen 1 point. And that has taken all of 5 minutes to arrive on the scoreboard for Greg Cullen. Port Arlington goalkeeper Ross McGrath ready to take this kick. His full backliner Owen Kennedy, Robert Pickett, Curtis Lyons Carroll, and his halfback line Sean Byrne, Dermot Bennett, and Adam McCann Carroll. In the middle of the park, he's got Owen McCann and Colin Murphy, wearing number 8 and 9. Colin Slevin as a 10. The captain is Jake Foster at number 11, and Ronan Coffey at number 12. And now we have a sideline ball. Jamie Connolly, who's on the score sheet, Jordan McCarthy, and Scott Osborne are the full forward line. And here comes Connolly again, lively. He's a thorn in the side for Martin Dial. He turns inside Dial, picks his spot. This time he doesn't curl it enough, and that is the first wide of the Leash Shopping Centre Minor Football Championship final here in Port Leash, and that rain is getting heavier, and the meteorological situation is not good for the Midlands and into Connacht. And an unusual timing for a minor final. Over the years, all was played prior to the senior final. The Leash County Board have selected Friday night along with a host of other games. Greg Cullen under 14s have won the Shield final earlier on tonight as well. And Greg Cullen managed by Tomás Brett, Colm Dorn and Michael Hand, better known as Birdie in the village of Greg Cullen. Here is the free for Port Arlington. They're looking to extend their lead. We're into the 7th minute. Colm Murphy, the man to take the kick. Oh, he breezes that one to the left and wide. I don't think there's any need for Hawkeye there. But that's two wides for Port Arlington. No wide for Greg Cullen. But conditions getting more and more difficult. Fine crowd in tonight as well. Fine crowd coming in from Greg Cullen and Port Arlington, all arriving here nice and early. Scoreboard still 3 points Port Arlington, 1 point Greg Cullen. Greg Cullen's last win in the minor championship was back in 2010. Prior to that, they won in 1992. And now the man who got the first goal is looking for another one. Luke Cann has done well. He needs support. Now it's with Brian Byrne, the captain. And he was tackled with a bit of ferocity, and Greg Cullen have won the free. Brian Byrne, of course, was a member of the Carlow CBS team that lifted that All-Ireland title back in May. Also on that team was Kyle O'Brien, Ryan O'Grady, who's a full forward tonight, and in the middle of the park, Trevor Collins from St. Clair's Road, Greg Cullen. And Greg Cullen now with a free, looking to reduce the deficit.
The 8 minute, and there it is.
A little bit of descent, and that was kicked from dead straight in front of goal. One between them, 7.5 minutes gone. Port Arlington 3, Greg Cullen 2 points. And if you just joined us, Greg Cullen, wearing their traditional green and red, playing from left to right. And the kick out will now come from the Port Arlington goalkeeper. Greg Cullen, in the history books of the Leash Minor Championship, had great success back in the 40s. Five in a row, 1945, 46, 47, 48 and 49. Lost out in 1964 and 65. And also in 1984 after a replay at the Port Leash. I still feel the pain. 3 points Port Arlington, 2 points Greg Cullen. That's all of 31 years ago. It seems like yesterday. But now it's the present and the future players of this club and of the Port Arlington club, who have a great tradition. They were founded in 1893. Greg Cullen founded way back in 1898. So Port Arlington, 5 years an older club. They're laying that ball off beautifully. And working well from the middle of the park. And now it's with Ronan Coffey. He got their second point tonight. He's looking for the third. He does well. He gets it to Jordan Fitzpatrick. Fitzpatrick saw a man outside. He's the captain, but he decides to go himself. Throws it a good block down. And good defending Greg Cullen. And then they got a hand on that ball. It was the right half back, Kyle O'Brien, who did well. Good player, very great. Good defending again from Greg Cullen. That's what you got to do on a night like tonight. Kyle O'Brien, I mentioned, his dad was on the 1984 team, and his uncle Paul was there too. Looking in tonight from Saudi Arabia, as Tunde Ogunfowore has gathered that, and now Greg Cullen has settled down. And oh, that's high. Oh, that's high. We have a free, has been taken quickly. Downfield, no great advantage there, but Greg Cullen kicked that away by taking it too quickly. Referee might have taken action. Poor Darlington player knows he was looking to get away there. As Ronan Coffey gets it to Jack Foster. Jack Foster, good heavy hit on him as well, fair and square. The runner is a midfielder. That's what they call barging with the ball. And I think the big number is Owen McCann will find himself a little unfortunate. But Greg Cullen, fielder lines, and playing into the Abbey Leach Road goal. Ball is a little bit overcooked. It will be tidied up by Curtis Lyons, Carroll of Port Arlington. He gets it back to Ronan Coffey. Now Jake Foster, their captain. Good running off the ball. And it was Robert Pickett who came forward that time. Jordan Fitzpatrick was caught high. Referee awards Port Arlington a free. One between them, good competitive game. We're into the 11th minute of a 30-minute half, and a huge crowd here tonight in Amour Park, Portlaoise. Lots of matches on this weekend in Portlaoise. Not for you if I didn't mention him at the start, but I do believe I did. David Moore from St. Joseph's, so we wish him well tonight as well. A concern for one of the great Cullen players at the far end of the park, and a few instructions being issued in. I think it'll be Dane Lyons as the man who picked up that knock, and certainly isn't he? Just limps away, should be alright. Backroom team looking after him there. Noel Cross, incidentally, or Cross I should say, Ivan O'Neill and Philip Ward are on the backroom team for Port Arlington. Ronan Coffey, lively player, gets in front of goal. This is vital into the bread basket of Kieran or Greg Cullen. Now it's out to Paul Mulready, man from Oakley Park. And back to Tunde. Oh, Ogunfowore. Fine full back, Tunde. He's adapted well to Gaelic football. As Greg Cullen cleared the lines. That's Ryan O'Grady. Good run from O'Grady. Lovely layoff from Ryan O'Grady. And in comes the wing half back, Paul Mulready. Good football. Good possession. Brian Byrne, the captain. Both him and O'Grady on that CBS team. Byrne goes forward. Class bit of stuff, this fella. Up to the full forward line. Gathered by Dean Kelly. Goal chance, Greg Cullen. Turning. Port have got defenders back, and Greg Cullen have overrun. But credit to Port Arlington. Good defending there. But well done to Ryan O'Grady. Came back, helped out his half-back line. Beautiful movement from Greg Cullen. And they know they can break down that Port Arlington defence. But it's now a free out to Port Arlington. Well, that's a very intelligent kick from the goalkeeper. Now what can Port Arlington do here? That's Sean Byrne in possession. Kicks it in quickly. Too quick. Gathered by Martin Dyle. Good hands, Martin. Difficult night for that. Was brave. And the kick ahead of Dean Kelly. And they give the Barrow Vale man from Greg Cullen. Nice ball player. Towed the hand three times. Needs support. Turns his marker inside a 45. What's his options? Lovely hand pass. Infield towards Dane Lyons. Turning, striking. Good goalkeeping from Ross McGrath, Port Arlington. Under the crossbar. Still 3 points to two. We're in the 13th minute, and it's a cracking minor final. The rain thunders down in Portlaoise. Plenty of shelter here. As the return ball goes towards Colin Murphy. Nice kick in from Murphy. Greg Cullen got to be careful here. And he's defended well again. Martin Dyle has done excellent work there. Now Jamie Sheen. Final out to Jamie. Jamie's from the numbers. And Greg Cullen a little bit unlucky. Dean Kelly did his best to keep that one in, and it just ran out of space. And the linesmen down there, Vincent Dowling and Arthur O'Connell, well earned their colour tonight in that weather. There's a quick ball in for Port Arlington. That's Ronan Coffey. He's already on the score sheet, takes return. Lovely player, Ronan. Has it all. Nice hand pass. Greg Cullen just want to tighten up a little bit in defence. Gets it to Colin Slevin. Colin's fouled. Greg Cullen just have to remain disciplined for the moment. Put the hand in high on the back or a slap down, and the referee will award a free. But still 3 points to two. But Port Arlington now with a free, and that's just inside, or outside I should say, the 21. The man to take this free decides to put the ball on the ground. Unusual for a minor to do that, but Colin Murphy is the man. He looks in at the town end goal as darkness falls over the skies of Portlaoise, or dare I say, the skies over Ballarone, just outside the road. He's pulled that. Ooh, and that could have been dangerous. But that's a third wide for Port Arlington. And they know that that was a glorious opportunity to extend their lead for just on the quarter hour. And Greg Cullen and Port Arlington are serving up a good innings of football here. 3 points Port Arlington, 2 points Greg Cullen. And the kick out is vital here now for the Greg Cullen goalkeeper. He goes back to get the team. Might be wise if they had a ball by somebody back there to retrieve the ball, because it slows down the game somewhat. Gerald Kieran places a dead centre in front of his goal. Big strong man in goal. Fine kick out too, to be fair to the lad. Oh, great Cullen are loose there, and Port Arlington read that well through Dermot Bennett. And Dermot Bennett finds Jake Foster. Dangerous player. Good tackling again, chased back by Luke Hand. Luke Hand's got his hand in there as well. And the Port man dropped that short. And Gerard Brennan will take it from the fence. And Greg Cullen will work that out of fence again. Jamie Sheehan. Fine, big, strong lad on the ball, Jamie. He gets it to Kyle O'Brien. Intelligent football, a beautiful return ball. Nice ball upfield. Referee saying a little bit of pulling and dragging there from Greg Cullen. A little bit over anxious to try and get that ball. There's no cost for Port Arlington manager, issues instructions. Tomás Spray and the Greg Cullen backroom team. But Colin Dorn and Michael Hand issue theirs. Ball is in the hand of Tundy Ogunfora. Tundy says we leave that there. And I think it will be a Port Arlington ball. And it will be Kyle O'Brien. I'll take this. Kyle is a multi-talented young man. Equally as good at all other sports as he is at Gaelic football. And he is one man that would love to get a minor title. 2010 was 5 years ago. All these guys were 11 and 12 years of age. Now here comes Greg Cullen now. Luke Hand. He got Greg Cullen's first. Can they get another one? Kyle O'Brien gives a good shout on the outside. Now it's with Dane Lyons. Oh, it's an intelligent ball, but there's a bit of work to be done. He kicked them a little further than he thought. There's a bit of pushing there as well. But to be fair to Thomas Brennan on the crook on, he did well, but then Greg lost possession. And now they got a chase back. Fair enough challenge, says referee David Moore. And Greg Cullen good in defence on a difficult night for football, as Trevor Collins, fine footballer too. Trevor, another one of those lads from the CBS team, has plenty of experience now for a young man. Back to Paul Mulready. Mulready waited for the man to give him a shout. Brian Byrne, the captain. Floats a nice line, looking for O'Grady. Big man Ryan O'Grady. He's over 6'1", maybe 6'2". Lovely return ball. Goes for the big one. That could be a 45. And that for me is a 45. And the umpire says yes. Good work from O'Grady. He tried to curl that, but to be fair to Port Arlington, got the hand in. A while since we've had a score. We're into the 18th minute of Port Arlington lead. 3 points to two here in the Leash Shopping Centre Minor Football Championship Final. The game that started just in around 7:30 local time. A few running repairs. The Mayor Ishkas are out there. The rain still thunders down. And a fine attendance here in Amore Park. Now this will be difficult for a minor on a wet night. After all the great weather, what a pity. We had electric picnic in this area last week, just down the road in Stradbally. Oh, he struck that well. He struck it very well. That's as good as you'll see. Dean Kelly, he put that ball down. He looked at the post and he said, here goes. Well, what a score from Kelly. And we're level for the first time in Amore Park.
3 points apiece, and that score deserves credit, but Greg Cullen need more of them if they want to win here tonight. Well done, Dean Kelly, the man from Barravale. Ross McGrath with the kick out. Fine kick from him, breaking ball. Oh, that's a great catch from Port Arlington. Good play by Colin Murphy. Sends it in field towards Jake Foster. Back to Dermot Bennett. Nice play again, distributing that ball beautifully. This man is a thorn in Greg Cullen's side since the game started. Roman Coffey likes to take on his defenders. Good to lay it off. Colin Murphy this time out to Sean Byrne. Byrne sends it in. But normally a wing halfback in the modern day game or a right cornerback or left hand side stick those over the bar. But ambitious from Byrne, he sent it wide. May make that four wides for Port Arlington. And which is a 20 minutes played here at Amore Park. Greg Cullen looking for their 10th minor title tonight. '92 was a good passage for the club as well. Referee more or less got in the way there. Greg Cullen tidy up. That's a beautiful ball. This is Thomas Brennan. Lovely, intelligent ball. Why no grid? Oh, referee, that's a terrible decision. He was entitled to play that ball. It was moving towards him, and on a night like tonight, there's no such thing as common sense in the book. And that's a harsh chat, a harsh free to concede. As O'Grady did his best to get to that ball. This time he said it was off the ground. He didn't have to go to Specsavers this time, our match referee. He's done well, and in fairness, he's having a good game. The St. Joseph's man, David Moore. Now Kyle O'Brien. Trevor Collins. Brian Byrne. Beautiful football from Greg Cullen. Paul Reedy runs into a bit of a cul-de-sac. Back to Jared Brennan. Likes to run at the defence. Jared Brennan outside the 45. Beautiful ball in. Ryan O'Grady catches this time. Runs away from his marker. Feeds it back outfield. That's Dane Lyons. Now Dean Kelly, who kicked that 45. Back outfield, sent in. Good score, Greg Cullen. Excellent football, and O'Grady with the finish. Ryan O'Grady took it well. He started the move, he worked well, and Greg Cullen have taken the lead for the first time tonight with 21 minutes on the clock. And Ryan O'Grady, who I know his dad does a lot of work with Greg Cullen Football Club, member of the Laois Minor panel this year, Ryan, and a huge Dublin supporter, I might add. He'll be looking forward to next Sunday week. Greg Cullen again. Here comes Tundy over for Warren. He's settled into the game now. Tundy takes the return. Back to his cornerback, Martin Dial. The man from the Loughlin Road sends it downfield. Beautiful turn. Dane Lyons. Looking to get it in across the Abbey Leakes Road end goal, or the Cork end, whatever you like to call it. Nice play, Greg Cullen, but can't over elaborate on difficult night for football. Dane Lyons again, that took a bit of a deflection. Bounces in around the house, this is going to be dangerous. Greg Cullen entitled to play that, to have it up. Looking for a score, that's a push in the back, and that's a free. This is much better from Greg Cullen. Nervous 15, opening 15 minutes. A nervous opening 15 minutes, but now with 22 minutes on the clock. 4 points to 3, Greg Cullen lead. And have a free from just outside the 13 metre line, and Ryan O'Grady will look for his second point of the night. He's got one from play. He's now looking for the free. And the crowd still coming into Port Laois tonight. Our cameraman on the gantry, working like a TV tree, RTE Satanta Premier Sports cameraman. And a fisherman on deadliest catch, Paul Dargan. Wet inside and out. Do hope you're enjoying. O'Grady has sent this one in. And he's got it. I thought to be a touch of Hawkeye there. It curled away, but it curled between the posts. 2 points for Ryan O'Grady, 5 points for Greg Cullen. And now Greg Cullen lead by 2, 5 points to 3. 7 minutes from the half-time whistle. And a very entertaining first half here in the Laois Shopping Centre Minor Football Championship Final 2015. course, with great famous players over the years, Steve Allen, Colin Maher, Benny Hunt, Seamus Hunt, Tom Smith, Adrian Phelan was another one, David Sweeney, Huey Emerson, Roger Goldwire, Damien Moore, Evan Bennett, all great footballers. Great Cullen again, defend very well. This man is a ball, that's a trip, that's a free out. Kyle O'Brien, he's really working so hard for Greg Cullen at right half back. He hasn't put a foot wrong all night. And he really reads the game well and anticipates what has to be done. And he's linking well with all of that half back line and full back line. And he's decided to take his free back to the keeper. And Greg Cullen will come again. It's all about possession. Floats a bit of height into that one. It's a wasted ball now. This is won back by Dermot Bennett of Port Arlington. The referee has given a soft free to Port Arlington, handing over the shoulder from the Greg Cullen man. Jamie Connolly takes it quickly for Port. Downfield towards the big full forward, Jordan Fitzpatrick, fine player. And he's looking to feed this back, that's what he does. Ronan Coffey, looking for his second score of the night. Coffey turns in field. Greg have just got to shut off his path. Great defending and got the hand in at a vital time. And the referee has given the free out. Absolutely fantastic defence. And Paul Mulready can get the credit for that. Outstanding play from Greg Cullen. Low scoring, but the elements are not helping here in Port Leash as that rain still thunders down. And the forecast is it's to get worse. The floodlights on in full now as the autumn evenings close in. Oh, the referee is given a free there. Greg Cullen a little bit unlucky. Two players, one losing his balance, fouling the Port Arlington man. And they've got the free in. It's a while since Port have scored, and they know they need one now to settle them down. And they'll be taken on the far side by Jake Foster, their captain. Centre half forward. He's had a good first half, Jake. Nice player. Just outside the 20 metre, or if you're my vintage, the 21. Well, he floats it beautifully with the left peg, and that's a great score from the centre half forward. So there's one between them with 4 minutes of regulation time remaining here in the Leash Shopping Centre Minor Football Championship Final of 2015. And really, the pressure was put back on Greg Cullen that time because they didn't clear their lines and played the free back to the goalkeeper, which in turn Port Arlington won on the clearance. So now they're trying to get back that score, Greg Cullen. Here comes Trevor Collins, beautiful player. Oh, he loses his footing. I can go to show you how difficult it is, but then he was fouled. Good referee. So the idea is tonight you've got to stand back a little bit. Let one of Greg Cullen's famous sons coming in. They're at Tom Chop Scully. Leinster final man, 1980. One, I think it was, if my memory serves me right, Chops. And the legend Willie Brennan is looking in tonight. Sent in a cracking score, beautifully floated with the left peg, and the man to send it in was Brian Byrne, and he's on the score sheet, and Greg Cullen have extended their lead to 2 points. They've got it back, 3 minutes to half time plus whatever additional time our match referee David Moore of the St. Joseph's Club has. A club that broke the hearts of Greg Cullen in senior championship many times down the years. Greg Cullen were beaten in the minor final on this day 50 years ago, but they won the senior. And they go forward again. Oh, the referee is overblown again. That was harsh. We'll have to look at that in the studio at half time. That looked a little bit harsh. My agenda in games like this, let them take one or two extra steps each team. Conditions don't help. And how many did the Port Arlington man take? And the referee said he was legal. Owen McCann plays it in towards Jamie Connolly. Handled on the ground, no free there. Back to Connolly again. He's already on the score sheet. He's left it behind, but he's a tidy little player. Greg Cullen throws him down. And Sean Farrell of Heather Hill gathers. Out to Kyle O'Brien, who's on the far side. Up to Dean Kelly. Good play, Greg Cullen. They're waiting for the runner, and there he is. He'd take it from inside his own 45. Return ball. Oh, that's a wasted ball. Conditions are difficult.
Poor Darrington win, the misplaced pass by Greg Cullen. Tundy says goal side. And here goes Jake Foster. Good defending for Tundy. Oh, good for War at fullback. This is some football now. Classic minor final. They're all slipping and losing their footing. But this man has been lively, Dane Lines. He's absolutely electric. Big ball in field. All right, Gallagher. Brilliant stuff. Thomas Brennan. Oh, what a score. Score of the game from Tommaso Brennan of Greg Cullen. What a score. 7 points, Greg Cullen. 4 points for Darlington. 45 seconds of regulation time remaining. And that was score of the game. Thomas Brennan from the crook on. He danced and strictly come dancing for Greg Cullen, and he danced in a more part there, left to right, bang between the sticks. That was back in November. He's done a lot of training since then. Poor decision from the referee. Owen McCann doing a bit of pulling. He got away with that. Crowd not happy. Port with a free in. Greg Cullen lead by 3. 15 seconds of regulation time remaining. They're giving it everything for Darlington. They're a lovely little football team as well. Two teams well worthy of their appearance in this Leith Shopping Centre minor football final. Now Colin Murphy. Oh, he's caught high. Advantage to the referee. Good advantage. Good refereeing. Sean Byrne floats it in. And Sean Byrne gets it. Credit where credit is due to the referee now. Gotta be fair. That's as good as you'll get from an official. And he used his common sense. Injury to a Port Darlington player. He's picked up a knock, and I think that could be Scott Osborne, their number 15. Looks in a little bit of distress, Scott. He's right in front of the Greg Cullen right corner back there, Martin Dial. On our camera. And let's hope the young guy is okay. We don't like to see anybody getting a serious injury on a difficult night. Not quite sure what the added time is. Fourth official hasn't showed that. We are now gone 40 seconds over the half hour. We've had a few small minor stoppages in this first half. And in a week that Kilkenny were crowned All-Ireland champions for the 36th time, Greg Cullen, I did say earlier on, a 10 minor championships. They're looking for their 10th minor championship tonight. That's a hand injury to the young Port Darlington man. Let's hope he's all right. He gets plenty of encouragement from his backroom team. All of these teams have worked so hard for tonight. He's okay, and Greg Cullen restart through Gerard Kieran in the goal, breaking ball. Greg Cullen really working well now. 7 points, Greg Cullen, 5, Port Arlington. Good old tussle there. Fair and square, says our match referee. Now he says we're going to hop that ball. Safety is paramount here now in difficult conditions. It's going to be a throw ball. I've got to be fair, I've got to say, he's doing his best. They all make one or two mistakes. So do the commentators. What do they know? 7 points Greg Cullen, 5 points Port Darlington. And there's a bit of a rugby tackle with Port with the free out. Port gather well. Dangerous player with the ball. Lovely footballer too. Jake Foster. Down to his corner forward Osborne. He gets it back to Adam McCann Carroll. Now back to Jake Foster. The captain is trying to lead the Port Darlington ship towards that goal. And the referee has blown over carrying on 5 occasions in this first half, and one will wonder, was any of them worthy of a blow, as he blows the half-time whistle here in Amour Park in Port Leash. And a huge applause for both teams as they leave the field. And the scoreboard up there tells us that with 30 minutes exactly played in the first half, it's Greg Cullen leading here in the Leash Shopping Centre Minor Football Championship Final. Greg Cullen 7 points, Port Darlington 5. It doesn't look like there's any changes for the second half. The only change is the rain is getting heavier and heavier here in Port Leash. 7 points Greg Cullen, 5 points to Port Darlington. And Greg Cullen will now play from right to left in this the second half, as our match referee David Moore from St. Joseph's looks to both ends of the park. 30 minutes of football. Will it be Greg Cullen to lift the minor title, or will it be Port Darlington? Greg Cullen win the first ball. Jamie Sheehan, man from the numbers, he lost it but he's won it back. There's a bit of a jersey pull there. looks like Trevor Collins, who did well with a bit of soccer there. Nice ball across field. Dane Lyons, good line in the first half. Paul Darren didn't defend well. Marie says Greg Cullen man foul. And the conditions are certainly not going to help either defence here in the second half. So 33 seconds into the second half, Greg Cullen with a free. Paul Darren, the midfielder, Owen McCann is explaining to the referee. He didn't think hitting was a foul. There's the free, floated in, and that's a great start for Greg Cullen. 3 points in front. And the man to send that in is Brian Byrne. He's got one in the first half as well. So Brian, the captain, from the collision road in Greg Cullen, settles his team down nice and early in the second half. As Ross McGrath, the Port Darlington goalkeeper, places the ball on his 20-metre line. And in fairness to that, it's a fine kick out in difficult conditions. But Greg Cullen are reading this game well now. Oh, referee. Luke Hand was on his bike. And he blows him up for over-carrying. Too many steps. Paul Darlington on the attack. Colin Slevin. Nice ball in field. Ronan Coffey did well. He's looking for his second point of the game. Paul Darlington shoot at goal. That's turning out. And that's the first wide of the second half. Finished with 4 to 5 wides in that first half. Greg Cullen's wides were scarce in that first half. Well, Gerard Kieran sends this one down to the middle of the park. It's Skids, no one there to gather it. Owen Kennedy hasn't got much to do in this game, but he's done that well. And to his midfielder, Owen McCann. Greg Cullen win that back. It's now with Jamie Sheehan, Kyle O'Brien, Gerard Brennan. Onto the left peg. Nice ball downfield. This is Dean Kelly. Good, lively player, Kelly. Beautiful ball, good hands in difficult conditions from Luke Hand. Luke Hand turns, kicks. Luke Hand has got score of the game. Oh my God, what a score! What a score from Luke Hand, a man from Heather Hill on the Portlaoise Road, has given the Greg Cullen lads a 4-point advantage 3 minutes into the second half. Good old Patton in the middle of the park. Well gathered by Port Arlington. The lead scores, and it's Owen McCann who leads the attack in the cavalry in the second half. Does well. All players losing their footing now. Fed it in towards Jake Foster. Dangerous ball in. But Jared Kieran says, I'll have a piece of that. And Martin Dial gives him the call. And Martin sends it down towards Luke Hand, who orchestrated and scored that last goal for Greg Cullen. The play breaks down between the 45 and 65. And Port Arlington will come again. Sean Byrne. Raised the ball. Sean Farrell of Greg Cullen tidies it up. Sean's a header, Hillman. Greg Cullen come again. Good player, Ryan O'Grady. Looking for his third point of the evening. Got a great stride. Lovely on the ball. Knocked away from good defence, but O'Grady wins it back. Nice ball. Sean Farrell followed him up. Plenty of support. Now Dean Kelly. Oh, beautiful kick from Kelly. Oh, what a score. Oh, what a score from Dean Kelly of Greg Cullen. The biggest lead they've had for the night. They lead by 5. The Port Darlington goalkeeper, Ross McGrath, has picked up an injury. But what a score from Dean Kelly. He kicked a 45 in the first half. He's now kicked an inspirational score in the 5th minute of the second half. And Greg Cullen have that lead. Last won the minor title back in 2010. And prior to that, it was 1992. 12 senior championships Greg Cullen have in Laois. 13 in Carroll, their last in 1925. Before they entered the Laois GAA. Also won the Laois Intermediate in 2007. After dropping down in 2006 for the first time in the club's history. they've bounced back and have held their senior status ever since. All's going well in the Greg Cullen club. Greg gets doing well, underage structure doing well. And even had the world darts champion over there playing football and darts, Gary Anderson from Scotland. The Lord Mayor of Greg Cullen is here tonight as well, Michael Lawler, just in from Ratniska, where the under-14s won the Shield final. So well done to them. The chairman Sean Duke sits watching on and hoping his team can hang on. So Ross McGrath is all right after a bit of a knock. Fine kick out from that young goalkeeper. 17 years of age, gets it out to his wing halfback, Adam McCann Carroll. And the wing halfback goes for Sean Byrne. Good ball for Burlington. Now Tundy's got to say go outside of his man, and that's what he does. Good defending Greg Cullen. They're making more than anything work hard for this. Just have to be careful as Sean Byrne followed up his attack, feeds it into Jake Foster. Port Darlington win the free. Jake Foster, the captain, scored one free already, but now his team needs scores. Half time. 7 points to five. Greg Cullen with three early points in the second half. Port Darlington now looking for their first goal of the second half. And it's Jake Foster, their captain, with the free from the 20 metre line. He struggled well, he's a lovely footballer. He's given it everything tonight. And he's got Port Darlington, their 6 points, there's four between them. And anything can happen, it's minor football and underage. Anything can happen, conditions slip up into the goal mouth. Port Darlington ready to introduce a substitute. Simba Chapwanya is the man to be introduced, wearing number 20. And we wish Simba all the best, wearing his blue boots. The man he replaces is the wing halfback, Adam McCann Carroll. Adam McCann Carroll makes way. And Simba Chapwanya, wearing number 20. As Port Darlington come forward, Colin Slevin. Nice little player too, Colin. Oh, lovely run from Ronan Coffey, who in turn gets it to Colin Murphy. Pressure on the break, Colin defence now. Port Darlington coming forward. There's a foul back on the 45. The referee had spotted that. Now, is he giving a free or was he allowing advantage? And if not, he'll bring play back to that 45. He's calling across Jamie Sheehan. No, he's not. So Port Darlington with the free. Half time score was 7 points to five in favour of Greg Cullen. And now with 39 minutes on the clock in the second half, the scoreboard reads Greg Cullen 10 points, Port Darlington 6. Brian Byrne with a free, Luke Hand with an excellent score from play, and Dean Kelly with an excellent score for play for Greg Cullen. Here come Port Darlington, Jake Foster again, floats it in with the left peg, sends it down, and the Wilds are mounting now. That's two in the second half for Port Darlington. And we are on 40 minutes here in Amour Park, Portlaoise. Can Greg Cullen win another minor title? 5 years in waiting. Big ball down, slips through the hands of the Port Darlington midfielder, Dean Kelly gathers. A little bit too high for Ryan O'Grady. I don't think Devin Toner would have got to that one. He's the tallest sportsman in Ireland. 10 points to six. Port Darlington warming up one or two more substitutes. Rain has eased somewhat, but it's still a very wet night across Portlaoise town. And a Moor Park and a massive crowd in for this minor title. The Leash Shopping Centre Minor Football Championship Final. Port Darlington. No panicking from them, just steady on the ball. Ronan Coffey. Big ball downfield. Tundy's at goal side, space opens up. Port Darlington looking for a score. and it is there. Scott Osborne is the man. While Greg Cullen went to close down the attack, it left a gaping hole and a beautiful precision pass inside to Osborne, and he's got his first point of the evening. And now there's three between them. It's only a kick of a ball in Gaelic games. 10 points Greg Cullen, 7 points poor Darlington. Just a bit of communication from the lads inside. Pick up the runner. One man stay goal side. That's all they got to do. Two men committed that time, left a space, and Greg Cullen were punished by Osborne. Greg Cullen have Dean Malone on the bench tonight. Jason Gagan, Ian Bradley is there. Conor Hogan, Oisin Hart, Luke Covington, Musa Suleiman, Conor Andrews, Ross Doyle, Conor Hayden, and Martin Power. Here come Port Arlington. They're getting a bit of a foothold in the second half. That's a good tackle though from Greg Collins, centre field man, Trevor Collins. That's a good breakdown as well. And good tidying up by Martin Doyle. And the man from the Loughlin Road feeds it back to Luke Hand, who's back helping out in defence. Now he's been fouled and he wins the free. One of Greg Collins' finest players tonight, Luke Hand. Two terrific scores he's got. 10 points Greg Cullen, 7 points Port Arlington. And the rain has eased off again. Greg Cullen have to free. Looking for options downfield. That's Jamie Sheehan. Good call from Sheehan. Working well with Trevor Collins in midfield. Lovely interlinking play. The run was from Mulready. Paul, the left half back. Down towards the full forward line. Greg Cullen, look at the cutter around again. Dane Lyons. Beautiful footballer. Back to Dean Kelly. Two scores for him tonight. Lovely toe to hand from the centre forward, Brian Byrne. Pass me the gear. His mammy Breeder very proud of this man. And his dad sitting in the front of the stand here tonight. Brilliant ball in field. Turning, striking, that's a block down. Hasn't got the pace to get to the end line. And Port Arlington, to be fair, through Robert Pickett, their fullback, have tidied this one up. They're under pressure to clear it, but Ronan Coffey again works hard. But Brian Byrne has read that well. Oh, he's caught high. Referee's giving him the advantage. Good player, referee. That was with Jamie Sheehan. And Sheehan sends it down to Thomas Brennan. The dancer from Strictly Come Dancing and the crook on just outside Greg Cullen Village. O'Grady playing well. Beautiful ball, Ryan O'Grady. Paul Mulready with the shot. Sends it in. And it's a rare wide for Greg Cullen. But that's a definite wide. But two good passes at play. Just no end product. And what a good Lee Shopping Centre Minor Football Championship final we have here tonight. So Ross McGrath to restart us again for Port Arlington. 3 points between the sides. We're in the 44th minute. And there's lots of anxious men on the backroom team now. Noel Coss, Ivan O'Neill and Philip Ward of Port Arlington are all issuing instructions. And the Greg Cullen bench down here to our right hand side. Thomas Brett, Colin Dorn and Michael Hand. Good feeling for Port Arlington. Good play from the right half back, Sean Byrne. Here comes the new man, Sinbad Chapwanya. Lovely ball from him. He looks for the return. He doesn't get it from Ronan Coffey. But Ronan hasn't given away any possession at all tonight. And here is Sean Byrne. The Greg Cullen have read that well. Brilliant play from Greg Cullen. Hammer bites the ball. That was Jack Sheen who did well there. Jamie, I should say. On goes Brian Byrne. Beautiful ball in field. Chance of a goal. Greg Cullen, can they get it? There's a shot. Oh, yes! Oh, what a goal. And what a move from the Greg Cullen man. That is a turning point in the game. But what a run from Byrne. And what a finish, and what a win of a ball from Jamie Sheen in the middle of the park. He's picked up a knock. The ball has gone to the back of the net. What a goal, what a finish. And Greg Cullen lead 110 to 7 points. As good as you will see. An injury to the midfielder. Play continues. Well, Darrington on the attack, 1:10-7. The official's having a word with somebody down there, but we'll stick with the game. 46 minutes, 1:10 to Greg Cullen, a total of 13 points for Darrington, 7. That's our play on the far side. Line ball, Greg Cullen. And he's got to go down and get that. He's been rock solid in the Greg Cullen goal all night. And he floats a big, big hand pass out to his left corner back. And Greg Cullen will come again. Paul Mulready. Beautiful hand pass. Brian Byrne, what a footballer. Cut down on the 45. And it's going to be a free into Greg Cullen. Luke Hand, the man that got that goal, is having some game as well tonight. One goal and 2 points for Hand. Quickly taken for Greg Cullen. They're playing good football. Dane Lines. Beautiful player. He's trying to turn that around the corner. Got a bit of a deflection. Good goalkeeper. Credit where credit is due. It's out for a 45. But Ross McGrath for Darrington, in difficult conditions, did all he could there to help his team. It's an uphill battle now for Port Darrington. We have 47 minutes played. Greg Cullen lead. 1:10 to 7 points. The goal coming from Luke Hand. Some excellent scoring tonight. Dean Kelly with an excellent 45 in the first half. A point from play in the second. Brian Byrne with some lovely scores. Luke Hand, Ryan O'Grady with 2 in the first half. Luke Hand with that terrific goal after some brilliant football by Greg Cullen. Here's another 45. Kelly to kick it. Bit unfortunate this time. He's had some game, but so have both teams, and I got to add, a good sporting spectacle for anybody here tonight, whether you're from Port Darlington or Greg Cullen. And I know the Port supporters won't be happy at the moment. It's not about the destination, as they say, it's about the journey, but the destination is the Laois Minor title, 4-3, they've taken it quickly. Greg Cullen have got to be careful. Trevor Collins is back there, helping out in the full back line. Tundy gave him a shout, but he's played to Kyle O'Brien, who's had a blinder tonight as well. Jamie Sheehan, Brian Byrne the captain. Back they go, just don't over elaborate, that's all they got to do. Don't over elaborate. Brian O'Grady is helping out. A well-drilled team, and the over elaboration has caught them in possession. And Port Arlington have won the free. Greg Cullen have just got to get that ball out. Port Arlington have got to get it in. When you work so hard like that with so many men behind the ball, life can be difficult on a wet night in Port Laois. Little or no breeze, mild enough, 15 degrees, and we're in the 49th minute. So here's the free from Jake Foster. He's a lovely footballer. He's got a lovely left peg. And Jake Foster has got another one for Paul Darlington. It's only the third point in the second half. Here's the kick out from Greg Cullen. They lead by 5, the Greg Cullen men. 10 minutes remaining in Amore Park, Port Laois. The Laois Minor Final, kindly sponsored by Laois Shopping Centre. And it's been a good championship. And it's been a good night so far for Greg Cullen. as Dean Kelly turns beautifully into Brian Byrne. Oh, what a player! Oh, he's hacked down, free in. He's given advantage. If it works out, it's great refereeing. And that's a tremendous score from Dean Lyons. It's little more than the corner forward deserved. He's a super athlete. He's a beautiful corner forward. And what a finish from Dean Lyons of Greg Cullen. 111 to 8 points. Now Greg Cullen are starting to play like Kerry. In the middle of the park. Carrying it downfield. Concentration, the name of the game. Porter chasing the game. Greg Cullen a little bit clumsy in the pass that time. But they're winning it back. There's a few tired limbs out there now. And it's still 111 to Greg Cullen. 8 points to Port Arlington. Nice ball downfield. Luke Hand again. A candidate for man of the match. Oh, still going. Luke Hand! Oh, he's wide. Oh, Luke Hand. He's put it wide. 111 to 8 points. We're in the 52nd minute. 8 minutes remaining. Port Arlington eight scores. And they need them quickly. 6 points between the sides. 111 is a total of 14 points. Port Arlington on 8 points. Ball on the far side of the park. Jamie Sheehan. Gerard Brennan. Lovely ball downfield. Just couldn't hold it in the breadbasket. Good play, Port Arlington in defence. It'll be fair to the Port Arlington lads. They've been climbing a hill since half-time, but they've given it everything. And this man in particular has had an outstanding performance for Port Arlington tonight. And this man is not bad either, Colin Murphy. He took that pass from Jake Foster. Now it's with Sean Byrne. A goal would put them really back into the game. Tundy says goal side. Can it foul? Port Arlington do well. In towards Foster, his path to the goal is blocked down. Again, a well-drilled Greg Cullen team defending in numbers, but Port execute that ball beautifully. The standard is good. This is Colin Murphy. Greg Cullen defend again. Rock solid a corner. That was Martin Dye. Not kicking it away. Holding possession. Back to Luke Hand. And he decides to say, we take away the pressure. And Dean Lyons sprints. Oh, the referee has spotted a jersey pull back up the field. And I think if he got away that time, Usain Bolt wouldn't have caught him in a Moor Park. 111 Greg Cullen, 8 points Port Arlington. 7 minutes of regulation time remains. Can they bridge that 5-year gap? Greg Cullen winning the minor in 2010. It was 92 before that. The new man for Port Arlington has the ball in his possession. Simba Chapwanya. Back out towards Roman Coffey. Nice play. Jake Foster. Greg Cullen. Just over robust in the challenge. But for me, and even though I'm from the west bank of the River Barrow, I thought it was a harsh call. Now, what will Port Arlington do there? We were always told as juveniles in Greg Cullen, take your points, the goals will come themselves. But Port Arlington need goals and they need them quickly. Will he take his points? He's a beautiful footballer, Jake Foster. He's their captain. Good sporting game. No yellows, no reds, no black cards. Stands to attention, Jake Foster. He needs this. So do Port Arlington. Ooh. Was it there? Umpire said it was. I'd like to see the replay on Flatley's camera to that one. 111 Greg Cullen. 9 points Port Arlington. There's 5 between them now. And there's 5.5 minutes left in a Moor Park as you look at that scoreboard. 111 Greg Cullen, 9 points Port Arlington. Here's the kick out from Gerard Kieran in the goal. Nice ball, good fielding Kyle O'Brien. Beautiful play from the wing half back. Nice ball out over the head of Luke Hand.
We have a large number of games here in the Moor Park over the weekend.
The referee for the umpteenth time has blown a free for over Carrion. When you do it once, he's got to do it all night. The stadium announcer just announced, due to the poor weather conditions, they're appealing to all supporters to stay off the field because there's lots of county finals and club matches to be played in Portlaoise this weekend. Big week next week in this area too, Ratneska. The World Ploughing Championships come to town. Electric Picnic last week, and Greg Cullen are having a feast tonight. 111 to 9. Can they hang on? 4.5 minutes remaining. Simba Chapuana. Outfield. Oh, the young man slipped his own McCann. Let's hope he's okay. Oh, there's a foul in there. This referee has given a soft free to poor Darlington. Said that at half time. You've got to be enough points outside the controversy. Greg Cullen are. Because a goal can come back to haunt you if you're only 2 points up. They're leading by 111, which is 14 points to 9. And if Jake Foster is successful here, it will be only 4 points with 4 minutes remaining, and anything can happen. Here is the kick from young Jake Foster. Well, he kicks that ball beautifully with the left peg. He's got another one. And he's put poor Darlington on double figures. It's now 111 to 10. And the Greg Cullen crowd are now getting anxious. For the older ones to remember back to 1980 in O'Dempsey's leading a senior final here by 2 points. And surrendered a goal to lose by one. It still hurts the Greg Cullen people. But they have a chance here now tonight as they come forward again. Kyle O'Brien, the number five, big ball downfield. On running through his Dane Lines. He's fast. Ball, there's a push. He's got the free end. Good play, Lines. He's picked up an injury, but he's had some game tonight. 3 minutes of normal time remain, and Greg Cullen lead. Looking at that scoreboard, shining in the nighttime sky in their heavy rains of Portlaoise Town. 111 Greg Cullen, 10 points Port Arlington. So the free is from the 13 metre line. On the far side of the park. Struck beautifully. What a kick. Brilliant stuff from Greg Cullen. Another turning point in the game. And even though their scoreline was safe enough I should say, you never know. But they've kicked that one, and kicked it beautifully, and Brian Byrne has had some game tonight, but he never lets Greg Cullen down. As I've said earlier, he was on the Carlow CBS team that won the All-Ireland. They had a tremendous Port Arlington keeper, steals a yard or two. I don't think we can criticise the young man for that. Ross McRae had a good game in goal, and to be fair to these Port Arlington chaps, they've given it everything. There's 2 minutes of normal time remaining. And Greg Cullen up to stay focused. Tundi has it. Tundi Ogunfalora of Greg Cullen out to Jerry Brennan. Oh, referee. Just cannot understand why he blows so many of those balls for the overrun. Let them play. Use your common sense. But to be fair, he has been good tonight, the referee, other than blowing them up. Tundi stays goal side. Got the hand in. Good play, Tundi. That's how to defend. Goal side of your man. 2 minutes of added time as Brian Byrne is back. The man that can lift the trophy for Greg Cullen. If they hang on, that's a jersey pull. Jamie Sheen and Trevor Collins have been outstanding in the middle of the park. Here they go. Lovely turn. New man on the field. Dean Malone wearing 17 for Greg Cullen. Not quite sure who's gone. Malone in for Lincoln with O'Grady. Toad to hand, Dean Malone. Nice little player, Dean. Loves his club, as do all these fellas. Very proud and passionate about it. Cross to Brian Byrne. He's in acres of space. A tired Port Arlington team now come to close him down, but he just wear down the clock. 45 seconds of normal time remaining. They won 5 in a row from 45 to 49, Greg Cullen. They won in 92 and 2010. They won in other years along the way. And now they're looking to lift the minor title for the first time since 2010. They're going the right way about it. Can they put the icing on the cake? The ball just runs away from them on the far side. Back to Brian Byrne. Byrne feeds it in towards Dean Kelly, the man from Barravale. And then Dane Lyons has just left it behind him, and Port Arlington have a chance. Is this to be the last throw to ice for Port? 2 minutes of added time. Colin Slevin. Good tackle. Brilliant play, Greg Cullen. They've really worked their socks off all night. And there's the ball back in from Dane. Was he fouled? Noses the referee. Port Arlington come away. Owen McCann. Down to the middle of the
the park. Jordan Fitzpatrick, their full forward of Cork. Big man, gets it to his midfielder, Colin Murphy, but it's overcooked. And Greg Cullen can sew it up here now. 1 minute and 40 seconds remaining. Dean Malone struggles to deal with the wet, greasy ball. He redeems himself, holds it well. The pace of the game has slowed down somewhat. Dean Kelly, he's just got to run into the corner with this one. Down he sends it, he's kicked it away. But Port Arlington lead big scores. Greg Cullen lead by five. They've run it back. Oh, lovely ball into Luke Hand. A real candidate for man of the match. He's been outstanding tonight. Sends it in. Oh, Luke Hand has been outstanding tonight. The crowd love him. Look at that. That's what it's all about. A man with a great tradition in the Greg Cullen club. The name Hand's synonymous with Greg Cullen. 1-13 to Greg Cullen. 10 points to Port Arlington. 6 points to lead by. And we've 1 minute of the additional time played. Luke Hand, what a game he's played tonight. What a performance by the team. And we got to say, some performance by the management. Thomas Brett, Tomas is a better one. Colin Dorn and Michael Birdie Hand. As Dean Lyons, a beautiful ball into Dean Kelly. Big one from Kelly. But that's as good as a score as Paddy Kelly used to say all those years ago at this moment in time. 1-13 to Greg Cullen, 10 points Port Arlington, 40 seconds remaining, and the Greg Cullen supporters are getting ready to go down and join their team for the celebrations as Simba Chapwanya of Port Arlington sends it across towards his number 12, Ronan Coffey. Big ball in field, can Port get a goal? It'll be consolation at this stage. They've got the free, 1-13 to 1-10, 6 between them. Those 2 minutes of added timer up. Here's the chance for Port Arlington. There's the shot. It's blocked down. That deserves to win the county title. That has to be the county title. Referee allows Brian Byrne to carry it out. Out to Ryan O'Grady and Greg Cullen. The Leeds minor champions of 2015. 1 goal and 13 points to Greg Cullen. 10 points to Port Arlington. No one must have wanted the pitch, but they're all on it now. Full credit to a cracking team. They'll enjoy this one from the numbers to Nigeria and from Governey Park to Guatemala. What a team, what a performance, and well done to Tomás Brett, Colin Dorn and Michael Hand, all the panel, and to everybody back at Greg Cullen Gaelic Football Club.
Cardiff, on behalf of the Kishna Foundation, it's been my pleasure to invite you all here this evening. I want to offer commiseration to the Port Arlington team. The level of skill and determination, the sportsmanship that you've displayed this evening, you surely deserve more. But sport can be cruel at times, and this evening wasn't exactly your day. To the victorious team, Greg Cullen, I want to say congratulations to them. I want to congratulate all sets of mentors and for their coaching and the exceptional skill that was displayed out there by both teams under the conditions. I think it's a credit to both sets of management and their coaching and to both sets of players. The referees and officials, I want to thank them for doing a fine job of the game. I'm going to start by presenting the match today. Greg Cullen, recipient. This is sponsored by Crown Paints, and if I can have, forgive me, Sunday if I get this wrong. Now on to the main presentation. I want to thank Leash Hockey Centre for their generous sponsorship of our leagues and championships. Very grateful for them, and ask you to support them on every occasion that you can. And without much further ado, I'm going to present the minor award for 1915. Sorry, 2015 to Brian Gordon. Thank you.
Asquilga.
I won't keep you too long there, the weather. First of all, thank all the support here tonight. Have to be fantastic. Just senior committee and Sean Duger, chairman, they were on the club for the support over the years. So cheers. But Ireland, I guess there's not much I can say to consultants right now, but a lot of us understand the disappointment now after last year. Maybe lads have a lot better days than this. Fantastic team, individuals there. There's a very good 16 team as well, so a short strength in that. For our management team, Al Malone and Kevin Smith, as long as you fly back in France there for this, but cheers for all the gym program, various stuff like that. For our management team there, Burry Hand and Colin Dorn. Two senior lads getting back to the club, and it's great for all of us to learn from them and hopefully go on and play with them in the coming years. So, cheers, lads. And on behalf of all the lads, and believe me, and Johnny Lawler, part of being the soundest man, we are on the best people ever. Actually, you told me to say that business card is written there. Well, I guess on behalf of the whole village and all of us, for one man especially, over the last few years, they say that people put the work in behind the scenes and come on for anything, symbolizing everything like that. They taught stuff on the pitch and turned themselves off the pitch. And for all of us, we owe them a lot. So, cheers, Brett. We started in January, February, especially after all this money we had last year. Come back. I don't even know how many gym sessions and training sessions all put in to get to here today. And the fight must have went up here now, it's all worth it. And I know for us as a group of lads, this doesn't stop here. We have high ambitions and goals that hopefully win the 21s. And hopefully win that one senior championship. That's just for one, but if I need to win a match, or each director at the moment and bring all on merit. So that's our ultimate goal. So pass the ball to us, just cheers everyone.